Hariyum, dear girls, in this video we are going to discuss how a C# .NET application can be connected to a MySQL database. Before we open the application, let me show you the MySQL database. I am going to open the MySQL command line client, which is a PowerShell, Windows PowerShell, using which I can create a database, create tables, I can manipulate the tables, etc. So in this MySQL database, I have already created a database called as test database. So let me say I'm going to use the test database. So it says database is changed. So my database name is now testdb. I want the .NET application to get connected to the testdb. And the user of the testdb database is test is the username of the test database. And password password is the password for this particular database. So what I am going to do, I have the .NET application which will be connected to this database, which is available in the local machine, and the user of this particular database is called as test user. T-E-S-T is the username and password is the password of this particular database to get connected. So to be more precise, my .NET application will connect to a database server where the database is available in the local machine. So the server name becomes localhost. Localhost is the server in which I am going to have the MySQL database. So server is the localhost and the database name is test database. It is not Y, it is test database. And the authorized person for accessing the database is the user called as test user. And the password for accessing the database is password. So now I can say, if I want my .NET application to be connected to this database, the server is specified as the localhost. Database name is given as testdb. The authorized person for accessing this database is the test user and the password is password. So using these credentials, I can connect a .NET application to this particular database. Now when you take this database called as testdb, testdb is the database name. What I am going to do, I am going to show you what are the tables available in this particular database. So I just use the command show tables. So I have now two tables in this particular database. One is sample, the other one is studdb. This is the database available, these are the tables available in my testdb database. So let me just show you what are the records available in the student database. So these are the two records available in the student database. I have a student name, roll number, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, and the total and the percentage. So for the time being, total and percentage columns are null values and the rest of the columns are having some values. So I have two records in the student DB table of test database. This is the database name and this is the table name. These are the two records. Okay, so this is the current status of my database. What I want now is I want my .NET application to get connected to this database and retrieve these records. It has to access these records. Let us also see what is available in the sample table. So sample table is having these three records, right? Name, roll number and percentage. These are the three records available in the sample table. So if I want to access the sample table from the .NET application, what I have to do? I have to connect my .NET application to the server which is named as localhost, to the database which is named as testdb, using the credentials user as test and password as password. This is what we are going to do in our application. I'm going to show you the application. I run the application and I will show you how it runs. Then we will come back and see how the application is to be developed. So I have already created the application. I'm going to just open the application. I have opened the application now. Yes, this is the application I have already created. So what it has? Let me change the size of all these things to 12. Yeah, so name I have, roll number, percentage, then I have three text boxes, I have two buttons. So what do I have? I'm going to run the application now. I run it. When I run the application, it shows the window. It shows the window. So the window has been created with all these things. And when I click get, it is getting the first record from the table. And you can see here the table. The database is having AAA 101 24.5 as the first record. And when I want to move to the next record, I click next. So it goes to the second record. I click next. It goes to the third record. When I click next, it says end of the data. So there is no more record. So I stop here. Again, if you click get, it goes to the first record. Click next, next. When you click next again, it shows the end of data, right? So this is a very simple basic application just to understand how a database of MySQL can be connected to a desktop application, .NET desktop application that uses C# language. Okay, yeah, so let us get back to the details of how this form is created and how this form is getting connected to this particular database. Okay, so let me minimize this. I close this window. I stopped the debugging. Fine. So since my application is going to connect to the table called a sample table, and to the test database. What I want, I have three columns here. Three attributes are there in my table: name, roll number, and percentage. So what you have done, three labels you have created, three text boxes you have created. And when I click get button, I need the first record to be loaded in the text boxes. When I click next data, it must go to the next set of records available in the table. Okay, so let us see when I add one more record whether it is getting connected. So I am going to add insert into table name is sample values. I am going to add the fourth value. Let me have the roll number as 104. Let me have the value as 68.9 semicolon. Yes, so it has added one record, right? Let us see what is available in the table. Yes, now the table is having four records. I am going to run the application again. Let me say get first record, next, next, next. It shows the fourth record now. I click next, end of data, and I close it. So this is how a form or a desktop application connected to the MySQL database. So let us see what I have done now. Okay, fine. So this is the interface I want for my application, which I have already created. Three labels, three text boxes for accessing the values from the database, and I have the button called get button. When I click the get button, the first record must be loaded into the three text boxes. And when I click next data button, the next set of records must be shown in the text box. So what I have done here, I have taken the text boxes, and you can go to the properties table. In the properties table, if you see, I have a property called as enabled. I have a property called as enabled, and I changed the enabled value to false. By default, it will be true. I changed it to false so that the user cannot type anything in the text boxes, because I want the data to be loaded from the table, from the database, and not being typed by the user. So what I have done, I have changed the text boxes to the value false for the enabled property. So if the enabled property is false, the text box cannot be accessing value, or it cannot have the text being typed by the user. The user cannot type anything into the text box. Okay, so that is what I have done. So all the three text boxes, the enabled property becomes false. So nobody can type anything in the text box. It can simply retrieve the data from the database. Okay. Now let us go to the button click event and let us check what I have done in the button click event. I double click on the button click event. Yes. So in the button click event, you can observe here. I have a try block. We have already seen exception handling. I have a try block. And in the try block, I have a connection object. And I hope all of you can recollect the points that you have studied in your JDBC application. In your JDBC application, you will have a connection object for connecting to the database. You will have a command object for executing the query. You will have a result set to retrieve the data. The same way here, In the .NET application, I am going to have three objects. Observe here, I am going to have three objects. We have, and please recollect the points we discussed in the previous video about the database connections, ADO.NET architecture. In the ADO.NET architecture, we have seen data provider and a data set. And in the data provider, we have seen different objects like connection object, command object, data reader, data set, etc., etc. So all those concepts you can recollect now. If not, please go and watch the previous video. And please see that this is just a very vague idea of how the application can be developed. We will get into the details of all these things in the next video. What are the different objects? What are the different methods available? What is the format of the object? What is the purpose of the object? All those things we will be discussing in the next video. So this is just to get a feel of how a database application can be developed. Now you can see here, I am going to have three different objects for my application: connection object, command object, and a data reader object. Just forget about this MySQL part. We will be discussing all those things in the next video. So I have a connection object called as MySQL connection object. I have a command object called as MySQL command, and I have a data reader. So this connection object is similar to your connection object in your JDBC application. Command object is similar to your command object, or let me put it this way, the statement object in your JDBC application. And the data reader is similar to the result set of your JDBC application. So these three objects are very important for me to get the .NET application connected to a database. Fine. Now what I have done, I have to create a connection object. So if I want to create an object, what we do, we generally use a new operator. So you can say new and specify the connection object here. And when you want to do the connection, what are the four information you have to provide? The server name, then the database name, then the credential, username, and the password. Fine. So what you have done now, the four information you have provided to the connection object. What are the four information you have provided? The server name, which is localhost, and the username, the password, and the database name. So everything you have given as a name value pair string, and this can be called as a connection string. You call it as a connection string. Connection string. The connection string is the one which is given as a parameter to the connection object. So once you have given this connection string, the MySQL connection object will be created, and I name the object as CON. So this is the reference for all my future manipulation, because whatever you want to manipulate, you have to give this particular connection. And I just check if the connection is equal to null, that means I don't get a connection, I don't get a correct connection. Then automatically connection will not have any value. Instead, it will have a null value, so that you can say it is not connected, or the database is not connected. Some message you can display to the user. Otherwise, if the connection is not equal to null, you can go and open the connection. Again, I repeat, please recollect the points you have studied in your JDBC application. You might have opened the connection object. Now, once you have done the connection, the next very important thing is you have to create a command. So command is nothing but whenever you want to execute a SQL query, whenever you want to execute a database query, what you have to do, you need a command object. So as usual, create the command object with a new operator, specify the class name as MySQL command. Then what query you want to execute, that must be the first parameter. What query you want to execute, that must be the first parameter. You here I want to select the records from the sample table, and whenever you have specified the command object, first argument will be the SQL, whereas the second argument will be the connection object. So this is the object to which I want to connect to. Then it will connect to the test database. Inside the test database, I have the sample table and I want to select the records from the sample table. Okay. So connection object is created. Command object is also now created. Now you are ready for executing the query. So if you want to execute the query, you have to use the execute reader method of command object. Execute reader method of the command object. So when you have execute reader, remember there is some result set which will be retrieved from the database. When you retrieve a data from the database, you have to use the execute reader method. So use the execute reader method of the command object, which will be returning a MySQL data reader. It will be returning an object of MySQL data reader, which you are assigning in DR variable. Then that's it. So you got the connection, you created a SQL query, you have executed the query. When you execute the query for retrieving the data, it will be returning a data reader object that is also captured in a variable called DR. So once you are ready with the result set, what do you do generally in your JDBC application? You will use a while loop to move from one record to another record. So here what I am going to do, since this is the get button, I need only the first record to be stored in this particular text database. So what do you do? You just go and read the first record, say dr.read method. This is similar to your JDBC application. You will say result set.read. Here I am using data reader.read. And once you have read, what you have to do, you have to take the first column value, second column value and third column value. First column will have the index as 0, second column will have the index as 1 and the third column will have the index as 2. Okay, so just take that value, convert it to string and store it in the text box. In the same way, take the second column value, convert it to string and store it in the text box. Third column value, convert it to string and store it in the text box. That's it. So when you do in this particular process that is related to the database manipulation, and if you have any kind of exception being raised in this particular process, that can be captured here in the catch block of this process. So the catch block will specify there is some database error and that particular message can also be displayed here. Okay. So when I click the get button, it will get the connection, it will create the SQL query, it will execute the query and it reads the first record. That record information is moved to the three text boxes. Now, so once you have retrieved the first record, you want to see the next or the following records by using the next data button. So just double click on the next data button. You can see here, I am reading the dr.read that reads the second, third and fourth records, etc. And again, when you are reading it, just take each and every column value here. The column values will be done using dr of 0, dr of 1, dr of 2. Dr is nothing but the data reader, and convert it to string and store it in the text box. Fine. So repeat this process. When you are doing this read method, if the DR is showing the end of record, it will be the DR.read will be returning a null value. So if it is a null value, DR.read method returns false. So if it is false, it goes to the else part, and there it shows the message end of data, so that no more records are there. Okay, then you can also observe here in the destructor. In the destructor of the form, I have the connection being closed. So the database connection is closed only when I close the Windows form. Only when I close the desktop form, the connection is closed here. This is a destructor. Observe here, this is a destructor. Okay, so this is a very simple process what we have done. So I repeat, if I want to have a database connection, the three important objects are connection object, command object, and a reader object. And in the first get button click event, I am getting the connection. I create the command, SQL command. I execute that command. A data reader will be created. I use the read method of the data reader, and I retrieve the column values and store it in the text box. The same is being repeated when I have the next data button. Double click on the next data button and add these statements. Now when you run this application, and you can see here, I told you the text boxes are having enabled property as false. So I can't type anything here. When I click on this name text box, roll number text box, I can't do anything. But when I click get, it retrieves the data and it stores it in the text box. When I want to move to the next data, I click next, 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 and it shows me the records. When I click next again, it says it is end of data. So this is how we connect a MySQL database to a .NET desktop application. So this video is used only to just show you how an application is connecting to a database. In the next videos, we will be in the upcoming videos, we will be discussing the theoretical concept of what is this connection object, command object, and the architecture, ADO.NET architecture, all those things we will be discussing. And apart from that, we will also discuss, if I want a .NET application connected to a database, how do you configure your application? How do you configure your MySQL database? The configuration part will also be discussed in the upcoming video. Thank you.